Link. My flower. It wilted. The joy met Lee's face when she saw this flower. I really wanted to see that. Poor Kamali. Anyways, hello everyone, God Ablaze here, and welcome back to more of The Legend of Zelda The Wind Waker. In the last episode, we went and finished up the Oath Temple after a long crawl through the dungeon with my friend Kamali 100 to help Medley reach the base of the temple and awaken part of the Master Sword's power. As you can see here, the Master Sword has changed its form. Its hilt has been restored to its former glory. As you can see here, it's no longer closed up. But the Master Sword does not have all of its power back yet. Also, while we're here, just for the heck of it. There we go. Take a picture of my. Oh, whoops. Nope. Poor Kamali. Anyways. We also have Mel! Good morning! Letters for Link, we have one letter! Here's your letter! Oh yay, more cash on delivery. 10 rupees is fine. It's not like Tingle's 201. Yo, how you been, man? I gotta tell you, you really helped me out there back at the mail center. I appreciate it. I've been trying real hard ever since then, but my postman skills are still weak. I just can't seem to hit 22 letters. I doubt I'll ever be as good as you, man. The postman! One of the postmen sent this pay on delivery. Really? Really? So anyway, I've been hearing all kinds of crazy tales about you. I figured I just had to write you a letter. You sound like you're doing some pretty amazing stuff, man. You're great. You're awesome. You're the man, man. You can probably tell that I had no idea what to write, but hey, I figured the least I could do would be to send you a letter of encouragement. So, yay, man, yay. Go, man. Go, go. Never give up. Never lose hope. And while I don't make much, I'm sending you the wages I own lately. Just doing my part. Hope it helps. I'm really sorry I had to send this COD, but I guess that's the price of fame. Take care. Thanks again, boss, from Beto. And he sent us a red ruby, so that's a 10 rupee profit, I suppose. Ouch. Anyways, though we started this on Dragon Roost Island, we are not going to stay here on Dragon Roost Island one bit. It is time for us to head off, for we are doing more side questing. Yeah, sorry, folks. I mean, we just had 4 episodes of Dungeon here, and the episode before that was getting stuff for said dungeons, so yeah, don't worry though. We're going to be getting some cool stuff here, more pieces of heart, more treasure charts, and more money, and potentially some more Triforce pieces as well. But yeah, anyways, let's head out. Okay, first things first. We are at one of the reefs for somewhere is one of the treasure charts here. Oh, it's in the reef. Whoops. Oh my goodness, look at all the purple rupees we can get. Again. Also, the reef's reactivated. How wonderful is that, guys? How absolutely wonderful is that? Come on. Oh, yeah! Who cares about the fact that I'm being bombarded by cannon boats and bombs and everything? I am getting money. Sure, it's only a purple ruby, but hey, it's money. Okay, fine, you're right in my path, fine. Since you two are repeatedly hitting me, there. take care of you. Time I go. And get these. Okay, here we go. And the Great Fairy Chart, which is what we came here for. Now we can find the Great Fairies and the Fairy Queen. There's just one sort of problem with that. Also, is this right on top of another? Whatever. This is one kind of problem with that. We've kind of already seen all the Great Fairies. But if you are having trouble finding the Great Fairies, here you go. This is the location of every single Great Fairy, as well as the Fairy Queen, as shown by the slightly larger Great Fairy. Oh, just Fairy there. So yes. Anyways, while we're at it, let's go and open up those treasure charts we got in the Earth Temple, shall we? And see where they lead to. Treasure chart number 12 leads to one of the reefs. Five Eye Reef there. While treasure chart, let's see, number 20 leads to Bomb Island. Okay, I do believe we are going to Bomb Island soon. And okay, that was it. Cool, okay. Oh, I'll see you at the next section that we're going to. Anyways, here we are back once again on Windfall Island, because there's so much to do on this island. Not that I'm complaining though, I like this island. Anyways, we've seen now that the thief girl here and her father, who were once the richest people on the island, have become the poorest. But we have not checked in on the people who were once the poorest on the island, who have now become filthy, stinking rich. So why don't we do that? All we have to do is just head up this staircase here, and go on down into what used to be Mila's house, and her father's. Now you can now see, remember that annoying guy who was constantly trying to pester us with the story of his poor daughter? Yep, he's super filthy, stinking rich now. You there, halt! Oh, you're just some wretched street urchin. I thought you were the postman. Be thankful, because if you were the postman, I would have shooed you out of here before you could say boo. But say, you look rather familiar for a street urchin. Have we perhaps met before someplace? Yeah, so not only has he gone from rags to riches, he's also extremely rude. And racist. Yeah, no one in the Zelda series really... No Zelda fans ever really liked this guy. At all. However, one benefit is... Oh, that pottery down there now that we're not going down there for yet? We can destroy it now. And he does not give a care in the world because he's filthy stinking rich. He can just buy more pottery. Anyways, if we talk to her... Oh, to think that I would survive my ordeal and return to this town. And to think that I would ever be able to live in such a beautiful, opulent house. It's like a dream come true. But no, it's a nightmare. Without him by my side, it's like a rainstorm rages in my heart. He was so kind to me in the Forsaken Fortress, that sweet boy who gave me all those expensive necklaces when I fled from that cursed island. Just hearing his name lifts my spirits. Mo, the wonderful Moblin from the Forsaken Fortress. Oh, Mo, why Mo? I'm always writing heartfelt letters filled with my overflowing emotions. But why don't you answer me, Mo? Ah! This is bad. Oh, terribly bad. I've already drifted off into my own dream world. Oh, by the way, I have a request for you. Could you take the letter I've just finished inking and deliver it to the postbox for me? Please, I beg of you. Sure thing. What? Really? It's such a deal. You've made Maggie so happy. And we get Maggie's letter. To a Moblin. Yeah. Wasn't there a book on this in the Minish Cap? I guess that book would be a reference to this. The postbox, don't you dare forget. You must promise not to read it. The secret of a girl's heart will be shown only when she so desires. Or else you shall incur their eternal wrath. Anyways, also, if we go up to this rude guy, if I do recall correctly... Not what I wanted. If we show him some skull necklaces, since he got filthy stinking rich on them, he's going to want more of them. They sell quite well at antique shops. In fact, it was thanks to these beauties that I became so filthy rich overnight. Eh, and from the looks of it, I'd say you have about 20 of these, don't you? They aren't easy to come by either. Frankly, I'm amazed you found so many. I'll be bathing in money yet again. The money bath, the only bath that gets you filthy. Filthy rich. Alright, boy, I'll give you this as a tip. Now, I'm not thanking you or anything. I'm just feeling good today. And we get a treasure chart for 20 skull necklaces from this real guy for making him even more filthy rich. Yeah, honestly, probably would have been better giving these off to Mila. I was once quite poor myself, you know. Back then, I used to dream of owning a boat. A boat I could use to go off and search a treasure. And now look at my filthy richness. Chase your dreams, little urchin. Stop calling me an urchin. Jeez, how rude. Anyways, we have a sea chart, so let's go check it out, see where it is. Okay, let's see. Okay, number two. That was easy enough. That looks like Rock Spire Island. Okay, cool. Anyways, now we just have to go and deliver a letter. Oh, that was I missed. Oh well. Here I am. Okay, let's see. Just use the postman bag here. And come on. Come on. Forgot to push off. And there we go, read the letter. Postage is only 5 rupees. Of course I wish to send it now. It's kinda already inside you anyways. And there we go. Now all we have to do is just head back. Actually, I think we have to play the Song of Passing for us, just for a moment. Play the Song of Passing a couple times, I think. Let's just do it, just to be safe. Okay, now that we are going to go back in here, we enter, and what do we find? Honestly, you just don't understand, do you? Open up your ears! Silence! I'm telling you, we don't allow postmen here! Be gone! Be gone! Don't be ridiculous. I went through great trials and tribulation to go all the way to the Forsaken Fortress and return with Moe's letter. Silence! Be gone! Be gone! Then please be reasonable. Can you at least sign for the letter? Being protective of your daughter is one thing. Being racist to the widows, though? You ugly person. But you are a foolish fool who is foolish because you have left your pottery unguarded. That felt good. Anyways, we have to go catch up with the poor postman now. The postman, where might he be? Well, He is in the cafe, cooling his feathers after all the trouble he went through going to the freaking Forsaken Fortress, dealing with a Moblin, and then coming here just to have a racist person yell at him for existing. Yeah, I don't blame this poor fella here for needing to go cool off. Oh, it's you. I'm sorry you had to witness me fly off like that over at Maggie's house. I'm most embarrassed. Never mind. To tell you the truth, though, I came to deliver a letter addressed to Maggie from a Moblin named Mo. But as you saw, the girl's stubborn father won't permit me to give it to her. What a stubborn, meddling old man. Refusing to accept letters from the postman? Who's heard of such nonsense? I went to great trouble to go all the way to the Forsaken Fortress, and it was a most frightening ordeal, let me tell you. If I don't deliver this letter, then I'm a failure of the delivery trade. But I have other deliveries waiting to be made. I cannot mope here forever. Actually, though, I have an idea. That old fool may not permit postmen on his premises, but surely he would allow you in place, would he not? Could you deliver this letter to Maggie in my stead? What do you say? Of course, anything for a reader. Honestly, you, young man, are a lifesaver. It truly never hurts to ask. I shall leave this letter in your care. And we got the Moblin's letter. Take this. It has a sort of stink to it. So I like how the stamp is like a Moblin nose on the back, though. Take it to Maggie. I'm counting on you to put this in Maggie's hands. And I thank you. Okay, off we go. You. Your father's a jerk. But I did bring your letter.
Is that... Could it be? The letter from Mo that I saw in my dreams? Let me read it this instant.
This is Mo. I like you, Maggie, so much that I want to eat you for dinner. Still a better love story than Twilight.
Did you hear that? Those words. This means... I mean, it must mean... Can it be?
That was the sound of my hand hitting my forehead. Just so you know.
You're so dumb. Suppose you having been poor means that you weren't able to go to school very much, but at least we got a piece of heart for it. How many pieces of heart do we even have? One! Okay. Anyways, off we head once again. Okay, while we're here quickly. More joy pendants for you, Miss Marie. 13 to be precise. Add up to a whopping 40. Oh, thank you, thank you. I'm so joyful to receive so many mountains of these beautiful pendants. I'm quite simply brimming with joy, my dear. To thank you, I have to give you my most precious of precious belongings. I shall give you this. Now, what we're going to get is completely different from the original game. We are going to get a treasure chart. This is a new treasure chart, one that I do believe did not even exist in the original version of the Wind Waker. But why the long face? Maybe because it's not as good, potentially, as what I got in the original game? In the original game here, when you go and give her 40 joy pendants, she gives you a special mask called the Hero's Charm. This mask allows you to see the HP bars of all enemies, including bosses. All you have to do is equip it. It doesn't even have to be one of the three equipped items in the top right corner of the screen. And you can just go around with the mask seeing HP bars of enemies. This mask still is in the game, it's just been moved to a different location. However, in the Wind Waker, she just gives you a treasure chart that was added into the game that was not here originally. Yeah, treasure chart 45. It's at one of the archipelagos, okay. No, basically, there are about five new treasure charts in the Wind Waker HD that were not in the original Wind Waker. Basically, what happened is, in the original Wind Waker, for the Triforce Shore quest, you had to find 8 different Triforce maps and go take them all to Tingle for his expensive translation service, at which point you then had to go and find where the Triforce Shard was. Well, that was extremely tedious and pretty much no one liked it, so in the HD version, they took 5 of those Triforce pieces and put them where the Triforce map was. So Tingle only has to decipher 3 Triforce maps. And because of that, that left data in the game for 5 new maps, so they just made 5 new treasure charts. Anyway, something else that's only in the HD version. Talk to this man and show him some score necklaces. Oh, chum, that's a score necklace! I collect these things, but how do you know that? Because I looked it up online. I can sell these for huge profit at antique stores, which reminds me, there's something I want to talk to you about, chum. Could you give me 3 of these? If you do, I'll let you play a really fun game. I'll give you 3. Thanks, chum. I'm happy to take him off your hands. Alright then. Now I'll let you play my little game. It's called Piggy Sitting. I've let these three pigs loose on this island. You have to bring them all back to me within 2 minutes. If you do a good job, I'll reward you for your trouble. Are you ready, chum? Yay. This is giving me flashbacks already to Andrew's cuckoo catching minigame in Minish Cap. Okay. No, I pushed A, I pushed A! Pushing A. There we go. Hopefully that counts. No, I'm all about catching pigs all of a sudden. Okay, come on. There we go. Oh, they're all fake pigs. Oh wait, what? Oh, that pig fell off. You, come back here. Don't you dare. Well, I've lost. Pigs elsewhere on the island, because he didn't register one of them. I'll just do this later off screen. Let's just move on to the next part. Okay, here we are, brand new island. The store bill, Shoot, how do you say that word? Ohipelago? I don't know. Anyways, let's see. I see money. I don't see the fish yet. See, can we do this without getting hit? Oh my goodness! It is right there. 50 rupees. We're going to get hit by it as soon as we get this money. But if we just hold this rupee above our heads forever, it will never be able to get us. But sadly, we won't be able to go and rescue Zelda and stop Ganondorf, so we're going to have to take the hit. Okay, stop you guys. Oh, there's a fish. Okay, let me see. Just get the bait out. Go and use this one since there's only one left. And now it's time to learn about another new island. Even though I already said the name, we can maybe learn a bit about it. And see that, for starters, this set of islands is shaped like Orion's belt. Hence the name. I won't sail on these seas on nights when the left half of the moon is missing. You'll regret it if you do, Fry. I'm warning you, it's not my fault if you get so scared you can't go to the bathroom at night anymore. And that's all the info I've got to offer. If you want to hear it again, you'll have to throw some more bait on the water for me, Fry. Sorry, but that's my policy. Yep. Anyways, as for these islands, there's not much to them. As you can see, it's just a strawberry archipelago. What we're really here for is that sea platform off in the distance. There are some cocoa rocks here, though, so I suppose maybe... Let me see if I can maybe get there some golden feathers, because I don't have many of those, and I do need them. Should the golden feather despawn? And that one just dropped arrows, darn it. That was so wonderful. Yeah, so wonderful. Got the golden feather to show up, and I didn't collect it in time. How dumb of me. Okay, let's see if I can maybe get a few arrows. I got one. Also money. You can always use more money. Money is not a bad thing. Money is always a good thing. Most of the time. Okay, sometimes it is bad. Don't let yourself get overcome with greed for money. Anyways, more money over here. And then we can go for the sea platform over there, which is really what we're here for. May have already said that, can't quite recall. I think I already did say that. But still, that sea platform is our true destination. For we have more money. That's what we have for starters, we have more money. We also have this guy right here. I'm so happy you don't get knocked out of the boats in this game. That said, goodbye. Okay, how come rubies come to the boat but the freaking golden feathers don't? Stupid cargo rocks. Anyways, more money. And now... No, I wanted to get out. Silly me pushing the wrong button. Anyways, we just have to get up here. Slowly climb up. Kinda wish this was like Skyward Sword, where you could go and... Skyward Sword and Breath of the Wild, where you could go and climb up ladders faster. But I struggle to think of that sentence, I don't know. But anyways, for this, we get, I do believe, a treasure chart for this. I was correct. We got a treasure chart. You see, we got treasure chart number 44 off of one of the Triangle Islands. Now, fun fact. This treasure chart does not exist in the original version of the game. In the original version of the game, there's practically no reason whatsoever to come to this island at all, besides just filling in your sea chart. I'm dead serious. It's kind of sad. But at least I gave it some points in the HD version here. Now, on to the next destination.